What I'm saying is that was wrong.
Wait, stop. Would you get over
trying to collectively
I asked you a question.
Healed.
Answer the simple question.
That's
would
the
you get over it?
These
somebody
are the people
your mama and your sister.
I would be upset about it, obviously. Who
okay,
wouldn't?
Would you forgive
but
them?
You have to move on.
No, move on my ass. No.
Okay, yeah. Doesn't that call division? Give me Luke.
Bring it out.
Give me Luke 12 and 51.
Bring
the brother right
out.
Here said that scripture doesn't cause division. Do you believe in Christ?
I believe in the Holy Spirit. I don't necessarily.
Okay,
believe
you don't. Christ. You don't believe in Christ? Okay, so then what are you up here for?
Right.
Okay, we gonna read what we gonna read what Christ said about division. Read that. Luke 12. Read
that.
The book of Luke, chapter 12, verse 51.
Read it out.
Suppose ye that I am come to give peace on earth.
So the scripture says, suppose ye that I came to give peace on earth.
Right.
This is
red
and red. Written by the black Messiah.
Right. Read on. I tell you nay.
He said, I tell you nay. I have not come to give peace on earth.
That's right.
Read on.
But rather division.
But rather what?
Division.
But rather what?
Division.
Christ, the black Messiah, says that he came to get division.
That's right.
So brother just read in Deuteronomy that you are a holy people,
right.
A
right.
Separate people,
right.
A special people.
It's
but you don't believe that. You believe that you're supposed to be on the bottom. No longer we are going to be on the bottom.
Right.
We're going to be above on top. But you must come back to the Most High's law, statutes, commandments.
That's right. In everybody.
Does that say everybody? Did that say everybody? That's what we're talking about. That's what we're out here for.
Talk to me.
No, I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna talk to you about what the scriptures say.
That's right.
That's what we out here for.
We out here for
the scriptures.
But y'all don't
we're not
word.
Out here for yeah, what I think. Give me Proverbs.
And that was written by
right through. How you figure that? How you figure that? Tell me that.
It was rewritten 42 different times.
It was. How you figure it was written by a white dude?
King James is a white dude.
Bring it out!
King James is not a white dude.
King James is not white.
King James is not white. King James is not white. Okay, hold on. Don't leave. How you want to say that? Leave. Hold on. Don't leave for a second.
Y'all don't even
let me show you something. Let me show you something.
Y'all want to keep reading that as book, but you don't want to have a conversation.
Okay, I'm about to have a conversation.
That's what I'm saying, bro.
Listen.
Can you agree with me that that book has been written 42 different times?
Listen, no. I can't agree with you on that.
Why not?
But listen, because I'm going to show you. You said King James was a faggot. Okay? Why would he leave this? Because you said he rewrote the Bible,
out.
Right?
Bring it out. Bring it out. The book of Leviticus, chapter 18, verse 22.
Just so everyone knows, he said that King James was a homosexual. And King James wrote this Bible. Now, if he did that, why would he leave this in there to condemn himself? It makes no sense. Read that.
Read the scripture. The book of Leviticus, chapter 18, verse 22.
Uh-huh.
Thou shalt not lie with mankind.
Thou shalt not lie with mankind. Read on.
As with womankind.
What is that? That is homosexuality.
Right.
Why would the guy that wrote this Bible leave that in there? That makes no sense. Your information is wrong.
Right.
Give me Colossians 2.
Let me ask you a question.
Bring it up.
Have you ever looked at anything that's not in that book?
You believe
in
You believe in stuff that you're taught from other people.
No.
You believe in stuff that you were taught from your oppressor.
I've done research.
And who'd you get this information from?
I've done research from
your oppressor.
Various different sources, fam.
The book of Colossians, chapter 2, verse 8.
Read that.
Beware lest any man spoil you.
Beware lest any man spoil you. Have we been spoiled?
Peace to them. I hope somebody finds something in this, but like this is kind of crazy.
All these different philosophies.
That's right. Through philosophy and vain deceit.
Uh-huh.
After the tradition of man.
After the traditions of man. We've been taught after the traditions of man. We have been taught that we're African American. We have been taught that we're black. We have been taught that we're Hispanic.
We are
none of those things.
Right.
We are God's chosen people.
That's right.
We are the true rulers on this earth.
That's right.
But you guys don't want to believe that.
We
want to remain at the bottom. You want to remain docile.
Right.
You don't care what this Bible says.
Right.
And it's talking about you. It's talking about your history.
Right.
Read it again.
The book of Colossians, chapter 2, verse 8.
Uh-huh.
Beware lest any man spoil you.
Meaning destroy you. Destroy your mindset from who you are.
Right.
Destroy you from the king that you're supposed to be.
That's right. Through philosophy and vain deceit.
Vain deceit, meaning nothing. Read on.
After the tradition of man.
After the tradition of man. Right. That brother came up here with a tradition of man. Right. Talking about King James as a homosexual. But the Bible says different.
Read on. After the rudiments of the world.
Right.
And not after Christ.
He don't want to follow anything Christ says.
Right.
Our people have been following this nation for so long and don't realize how to get the kingdom of heaven.
That's right. Now,
sinning is not going to get you the kingdom of heaven.
That's
why we are here to show you your sins so you may change and get the kingdom of heaven.
That's right.
Read on.
Know ye not that ye are the temple of God?
Know you not, brother, that you are the temple of God.
Right.
Read on.
And that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you.
The Spirit of God is supposed to dwell in you, brother.
If any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy.
If any man defile the temple of God by smoking cigarettes, by smoking weed, by putting drugs into your system,
right,
him will God destroy.
That's right.
How is he going to destroy you? With lung cancer. With all these different types of cancers that's coming around.
Right.
Matter of fact, if you're doing drugs, how is he going to destroy you? Other nation's going to come and lock you up.
Bring it out.
That's a possibility. It might not have happened yet, but it is a possibility.
Right.
Right. Read it again.
The book of 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 16.
Uh-huh.
Know ye not that ye are the temple of God?
Uh-huh.
And that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you.
Uh-huh.
If any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy.
So God will destroy. The wages of sin is death. God will destroy you for defiling your temple. And that's what we're out here to do. We're out here to give you brothers and sisters warning. Give me Ezekiel 3:17.
Bring it out.
We're out here to give you brothers and sisters warning.
You can't get over that.
Because the Most High God is coming back to destroy the two-thirds that will not repent.
That's right.
Read that.
The book of Ezekiel chapter 3, verse 17. Son of man, I have made thee what?
What I'm saying is that was wrong.
Wait, stop. Would you get
You're
over
trying
it?
To collect
I asked you a question.
Healed.
Answer the simple
problem.
Question.
That's
would
the
you
problem.
Get over it?
These
somebody
are the people
read your mama and your
sister. I would be upset about it, obviously. Who
okay,
wouldn't?
Would you forgive
but
me?
But you have to move on.
No, move on my ass. No.
All right, so hate white people that had no hand in that crime at all. Hate white
really?
People that had no
really?
Hand in any of that.
Really?
Really.
Really?
It was
arguing. He wants to know, what would you do if somebody raped your mother,
bring
raped
out.
Your sister? This is part of the scriptures. These are the curses in the scriptures. Give me that. Deuteronomy 28 and 30.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 30.
Uh-huh.
Thou shalt betroth a wife.
So us Israelites, our blacks, Hispanics, we will betroth a wife. We will have a wife, right? Hey brother, listen to this. Read on.
And another man shall lie with her.
Read again.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 28
verse
30.
Brother, with the do-rag.
Okay.
Brother, with the do-rag.
So what the hell do you know, man?
Brother, with the do-rag.
What do you know talking about the new plantation is jail and all this crap? No, it's not.
Yeah, the new jail is
everybody in jail was arrested for a crime. And
so
that's why they got arrested.
So you will betroth the wife and another man will lie with her. What is that? That is talking about rape. What did they do to our people? What did they do to our people in slavery? They raped our sisters.
That's right.
They raped our mothers. They raped our grandmothers. But he don't want to pay for them atrocities. He think he should run and walk around here like he runs stuff.
Right.
But you are supposed to be the true gods of the earth. But you brothers don't want that. Read it again.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 30. Thou shalt betroth a wife.
Hold on, brother. Brother right here.
He say, get over it. If somebody raped his mother, his sister, his kinfolk, you can't get over that.
He said, get over it. All right, so I'm going to read something to you out of the scripture. Matter of fact, give me Deuteronomy 28, 46.
Bring it out.
Deuteronomy 28, 46. Because the Most High said that he's going to leave these curses for you for a sign to realize who you are today, brother. He told you to get over it. Hell no, we're not getting over that.
That's right.
He must be out of his damn mind for us to get over that. Are you crazy?
Bring it out. The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 46.
Uh-huh.
And they shall be upon thee for a sign and for a wonder.
So they are the curses. They're going to be upon us people for a sign and for a wonder.
Right.
So that our people in these last days can realize who they are.
Right.
Okay, now give me that Deuteronomy 28 and 30. Now this is going into what you were talking about, that he said we should get over. Read that.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 30.
Right. Also, I just want to make a point real quick. Did they forget 9/11? Or are they still making wars about that thing?
Right.
Bring
it
up. 9/11.
Right.
They tell you to get over the rape of your mother, of your sister,
That's right.
of your wife, Right. Are you out of your mind? We're not getting over nothing.
Oklahoma.
The only thing we're getting over is sin. Read that.
Thou shalt betroth a wife.
So you betrothed a wife. In slavery, you had a wife. You wanted to get married to this woman. You loved this woman. But what happened?
And another man shall lie with her.
Another man should do what?
Lie with her.
Another man shall have sex with your wife before you could.
That's right.
That's right.
Are we supposed to believe that? We supposed to run with that?
Yeah. Bring it up.
You want us to remember Columbus Day? Where they came over here and raped our people?
That's
stole
right.
Stole this land? Hey. And they want us to remember that? Nah, we're not getting over nothing.
Bring it up.
Read it again.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 30. Thou shalt betroth a wife.
So you shall have a wife. But what's going to happen to that wife? Read on.
And another man shall lie with her.
Another man shall rape her.
Hey.
Bring it up.
That's what the scriptures is talking about.
That's right.
The scriptures is talking about you knowing who you are in these last days. And how are you going to do that? By these curses in the Bible.
That's right.
Deuteronomy 16.
Bring it up. The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 16.
This is another curse. So we must realize who we are in these last days. Read that.
Cursed shalt thou be in the city.
Cursed should you be in the city. Who's cursed in this city? Getting shot down in the streets with your hands up.
Right.
Getting shot down for nothing.
Right.
Getting oppressed by young people and other nations.
Right.
We cursed in the city. We at the bottom of society.
That's right.
How are we going to get out of that thing, though?
Bring it out.
Once you tried everything. You tried marching. You tried protesting. Okay. How about trying keeping God's commandments? How about that?
That's right.
When was the last time we tried that? Read it again.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 16.
Start at 15.
Verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So this is what the Most High God said. And he said, if you do not want to listen to him, this is what's going to happen to you, Blacks, Hispanics, and Indians. Read on.
To observe, to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So if we don't want to listen to God, all these laws, all these curses are going to come upon us and overtake us. What's one of those curses? Smoking and defiling your temple.
Right.
He said it's going to destroy you. Give me verse 61. Let's see, or is it 60?
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 61. Also, every sickness and every plague which is not written in the book of the law, then will the Lord bring upon thee until thou be destroyed.
So, defiling your temple is one of those things that the Most High said will destroy you. Lung cancer and all these other sicknesses. So our people must come out of that thing. Matter of fact, let's get another curse. Let's get another curse. We must realize that the Hispanics is our people too. What's going on with them today in the news? Anybody know what's going on with the so-called Mexicans today in the news? They are being, the kids are being separated from their parents. Oh, don't walk away now. But the kids are being separated from their parents. Let's see if the scriptures is talking about that.
Bring it out. The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people. That's is that right. not happen today?
Right.
Is the so-called Mexicans not being taken, the kids being taken away, being put in cages, crying for their mother, crying for their father?
Right.
That's what's going on today. And they're fitting the curses.
That's
so what is the Most High God trying to show you, Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians? He's trying to show you that you are the true Israelites.
That's
you are the chosen people of God. A lot of people don't do that because they don't read. And when somebody's trying to teach you, they don't want to know. Our people are destroyed. They need to come out of this mindset. Give me, and don't think I'm just talking. Let's see if the scriptures say that. Hosea 4 and 6. Hold that.
Bring it up.
Hosea chapter 4, verse 6. Because our people are destroyed. They have let this nation teach them their customs and their ways. So that's why we read, you must come out of that.
The book of Hosea, chapter 4, verse 6. My people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge.
You hear that? God said, my people, you so-called Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians, my people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. What is that knowledge? The laws towards God. You are destroyed because you don't know those laws.
Right.
You don't know not to be a
a homosexual.
Right.
You don't know not to smoke cigarettes.
Right.
You don't know about the Sabbath. You don't know about the Most High holy days.
Right.
About keeping the beard, about your fringes. But that's what we out here for. That's what the prophets are out here for, to give you warning. So now that you do know.
Right.
Because thou hast rejected knowledge.
Because you rejected the Most High God knowledge.
I will also reject thee.
Now you're getting shot down in the streets with your hands up.
Right.
Now your sons and daughters is being taken away from you because you rejected God.
Right.
So now he rejected you. So now what are you going to do? Return. Repent. Come back to the Most High God.
Right.
Learn who you are. Learn your nationality. And that's what we out here for.
Right.
To show you who you are. No longer should you be listening to these lies that these schools are teaching our people.
Right.
Matter of fact, how's somebody going to take you into captivity and then tell you about yourself? Tell you how you should walk in this earth. Give me Lamentations 4 and 17.
Bring it up.
Lamentations chapter 4 and 17.
Bring it up.
People look up to this nation, and this nation have never, ever done anything for us.
That's right. Besides
keep us down and keep us on the bottom.
The book of Lamentations, chapter 4, verse 17.
Uh-huh.
As for us, our eyes has yet failed for our vain help.
Uh-huh.
In watching, we have watched for a nation that could not save us.
You see that? We have watched for a nation that could not save us. Oh, let's march. Maybe they'll change their ways. Oh, let's protest. Maybe they'll change their ways. No. They're not appeasing you for nothing.
That's right.
They're still killing our people.
Right.
They've been killing our people since they came over here.
Right.
They've been stealing from us since they came over here.
That's right.
We've been building up their kingdom since we got over here.
That's right.
No longer are we going to do that. Won't you build your community? Build your kingdom.
Bring it out.
They hunt our steps that we cannot go in our streets.
You hear that? They hunt our steps. What do you gotta tell your kids nowadays? You gotta tell them, be careful. Be careful what might befall you when you walk outside the house.
Right.
If you get pulled over, make sure you have your, why do we have to do that? Make sure you have your license and your registration in hand so they don't think you're reaching for something. Read it again.
The book of Lamentations, chapter 5, verse 18.
Uh-huh.
They hunt our steps.
They hunt our steps. They are oppressing us. They are the true terrorists.
Bring it up!
A lot of people don't believe that. They walk hand in hand with their oppressors.
Right.
They love the state that our people are in.
Right.
They don't want to change.
That we cannot go in our streets. Our end is near. Our days are fulfilled.
Uh-huh.
For our end has come.
For our end has come. We out here now to give you warning so you can come out of that mind state. Go back to Ezekiel 3 and 17.
Bring it out.
Give my people warning. For what? So we can save your life. That's what we out here to try to do.
Right.
Again, we're going to let the scripture say it, though.
The book of Ezekiel, chapter 3, verse 17.
Right.
Son of man.
Son of man. You blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. Son of man.
I have made thee a watchman.
I have made thee a watchman. What does it mean to be a watchman? It means to be vigilant. To watch over your people,
right.
To watch for danger. He said, I made you a watchman. Read on.
Unto the house of Israel.
To the house of Israel, you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians.
Right.
We're a watchman to you. Watching out for your soul. Telling you what you must do to get the kingdom of heaven.
Therefore, hear the word at my mouth,
uh-huh.
And give them warning for me.
Read that again, give them what?
Give them warning for me.
The Most High God says, my prophets, go out there and give our people warning. For what? For what purpose?
When I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die.
When I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die. Meaning, if you're in the midst of sin, and when Christ returns, you will surely die because of that sin.
That's
you will not be able to get the kingdom of heaven. So that's why we're out here, to give you warning so you may obtain the kingdom of heaven.
Yeah, right. Right.
And thou givest him that warning,
uh-huh.
Nor speakest to warn the wicked,
uh-huh.
From his wicked way to save his life.
To do what?
To save his life.
To do what?
To save his life.
That is the purpose for us being out here, to save your life, to teach you who you are, and show you what our customs is.
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.